Hello there and welcome back to Let's Play XCOM Enemy Within. I am the RNGenius, but you may call me Eric, and in the last episode we struck a UFO landing site that we're not gonna see on this globe. We captured an outsider alive. The UFO landed around here somewhere in Asia. We captured the outsider alive. We're currently researching that outsider shard. We got a lot of resources out of it. We got 120 alloys and I think 32 illyrium. And we got the UFO power source intact out of it. And we got a flight computer. So we are flight computers and nexus, building a nexus are two different things, right? Nope, we've got the two UFO flight computers. We just need cash and engineers, basically. Oh, this satellite nexus would be so juicy. That would be six additional satellites. That's all I need, isn't it? That's win the game. it's not win the game. That's oh my gurdy gumdrops. Then I only need two more. That would be dope. Well, it's not happening right now. I'm sorry, I don't like having to tell you that, but that's not happening right now. Currently, we're researching the Outsider Shard. Our strike team is quite potent at this point in time. And actually, I should go to, like, genetically engineer those suckers a little bit. I think we got something called Second Heart. I'd like my favorite claymore to have this. Secondary heart causes soldiers to bleed out instead of dying the first time they go to zero health in a mission. The bleed out timer is extended by two turns, also prevents loss of will from critical wounds. I don't plan on having this guy get critically injured, but it's good to have, you know, a second heart, but this is so costly. Don't want to do that. Like, this is an ridiculous. I don't even know why this is so goddamn expensive. I mean, okay, I get it. It's invisible mode, but still, you don't have to. I'm not gonna crunch all my mail down because we're not gonna get much more. This is probably as much mail as we're ever gonna have. So let's just save it for a rainy day. I don't think Exalt can take the mail away either. I think they can sabotage you to lose credits, which sucks big time because it's percentage based. So that's why I have I'm calling it few, but it's not a few credits because we're saving up for the damn Nexus. Anyways, let's do something. Let's do something, but I don't know what. We want to visit the memorial. Definitely not. Do I have medals? I have the Cautious Corporal. Medkits heal more. That's nice. How does this look? Cautious Corporal is the shield. Okay. Scun is this, my support has one, and my mech has one. That means I'm gonna give one to my main heavy as well. My main heavy. Except. Very happy. Very happy about it. You can see it in her face. Alright, that's that. Anything else? I'm trying to think of it here. I managed to build one of these plasma cannons, but honestly, I'd feel more comfortable having three of them around. This is so ridiculously expensive, though. That's the problem you have when you put satellites all over the world, though. There's going to be more UFOs than you can even think of, and it's going to be... It's gonna suck if you let some of them get away because the council's not happy when you do that. I think I equipped the one in North America with a plasma cannon. I'll buy one more. I hate doing this. I hate doing this. That's like 60% of my... No, that's ridiculous. That's a lot of resources. Okay, view ship list, which one... North America, that's right. And which country or which continent is looking the worst? That's the situation room. Ah, that is the situation room. Good. Europe is looking decent by now, but Asia is looking awful. So I'm gonna go to Asia and build a build a plasma cannon to this bad boy and hope that's gonna work out. Alright. That was clever. So, let's get on to... Wait, there was something about covert ops. Covert operations. Intel scan. Cost $50. The Exalt base is not in Canada. And what do I do? What happens when I do Intel scan? Executing a worldwide Intel sweep will cost $50. Ugh, man, I don't know what they're gonna do, but in the end, they're probably gonna steal $50 from me, so I think that might be worth, and they do increase panic. I have zero experience with Exalt. I don't know if this is... Unidentified targets, but nothing that requires our attention just yet. I don't know if this is worth it, but we'll try. Positive ID on Exalt cell locations. You, my friend, you've got to go. You've got to go. Not in that country, or not on that continent. You're gonna no. Okay, we're gonna need our lightning reflexes. Mew all day Fuji. Exactly. You get flush. That's nice for your tactical sense, run and gun. One of the better characters to have as a covert operative. So you're gonna go. Send operative on mission. Deployed to disrupt Exalt cell in Australia. So in Egypt, I could send one as well. Exalt operative already engaged, so I cannot have two engage at the same time. Things are definitely picking up out there. We'll have to monitor our available resources carefully. That's good. That's good. I'm not monitoring our resources carefully. That's not good, but this is good. So, let's scan. Assholes! Why?
Commander, we have multiple reports of new abductions in progress. The locations are marked on the hologlobe.
Not in Africa, man. Oh, Jesus Christ. Not in North America. Oh, choosing between the devil or hell. Yeah. You're not gonna... I don't need another support. So it's Mexico or Japan. Let's look at this. All of North America is looking awfully. The countries in... Asia don't have, most of them don't have satellites though. But if I don't go to Japan, like China's gonna be on 4 and these three countries are gonna be on 5. Panic, and here's there's gonna be 2 countries on 5 panic. But alas, these two countries are also more valuable because of the United States, and I cannot lose them. God, this sucks, but I don't want to lose these either. Why can I not split up teams, I wonder? If I go to Japan, panic is going to be decreased by a lot, though. I think by 3. Mexico would be the same. So I don't have to worry about Japan anymore from that point on. Several contacts, but nothing like that. All right, we'll look into it. So after that, my problem is solved a tiny bit for Asia, but Northern America and South Africa is going to go to 5 as well. That's nothing I can do anything about. But there, we can also deploy a satellite there, so that's okay. But the United States, I don't have this get out of jail free card anymore. And what day is it? The 11th of June. I don't. Oh God, I'm not gonna get any satellites till the end of I won't get any satellites online. I won't. So I'm gonna have to bank on a very good panic mission or something. So this is basically a choice. What country do I not want to lose? I can choose between three countries in Asia or two countries in the United States. In Northern America. And that could decrease panic in Australia if I do it successfully. So Australia is good. Luckily, I don't have to worry about Europe right now. South Africa, I'm gonna think of something. So I think I'll go to Northern America, because panic in Mexico is gonna decrease by 3 if I do this, and we'll have to just see what happens here. I don't know. That blows. That was an unlucky draw. No, by now there is no lucky draws, I have to say. There is none. So, Mexico it is. Acapulco. Let's do this. You have a... Is that a Gatling gun? That has to be a Gatling gun. That's my sniper rifle. Yeah. I'm not gonna take 2 supports. Assault, support, sniper, heavy, mech. What do I want out of this mission? Do I still want weaponry? I wonder. Who do I want to capture by now? We have captured... we've already captured mutants. I think at this point it starts getting less valuable capturing people. It's never going to stop being... it's never going to start being useless, but... It's not that valuable anymore because we have so many light plasma rifles. We don't have enough people to equip them all. I guess I'll take... I mean, the stunner at this point is not that big of an inventory fill-up thingy anymore. But, not necessary either. I think we'll take a rookie this time. But you do want to scream, come on, shoot me please. I'm not experienced at all. There you go. It's nice. And your loadout is not ideal either. I don't have anything better than your body armor, I'm sorry. I can give you a light plasma rifle. Or an exalt assault rifle. Where's the difference? 2 to 4, 10 crit chance, 5 to 7 crit. 2 to 4, 10 crit chance, 5 to 7 crit. They use the exact same weapons as we do. Ha. You take the light plasma. Don't have the access to plasma pistols. You can take a flashbang and a respirator implant. I don't know what that does. I think it, well, prohibits strangulation or something. You are equipped body armor, weaponry, and items for the assault. Is that body armor? That's body armor. Yeah, that's carapace armor. And well equipped. You're as well equipped as you're gonna get. I would very much like a better sniper rifle. And same goes for the Gatling gun. But that's not happening at this point because it requires research. And we don't have research. And mech trooper. Am I gonna take her with me? Why not? Okay, let's do this.
We're going to be putting down in Mexico for this mission. We've gotten several reports indicating that the aliens have stepped up the number of attempted abductions. We'll have to move quickly if we want to slow the spread of panic.
Yeah, this is not the way to slow the spread of panic, but still. Fading breath. Mission objectives. Neutralize all hostile targets. Locate and secure the meld. This should be a pretty quick mission because we know what we're gonna have to do. Don't take any chances with cover. There's going to be seekers. There's going to be mutants. Maybe a couple of thin men. Floaters. Nothing really big.
Strike one is cleared to engage hostile targets.
This down here is the end of the map. We started in the very corner. And let's see where this goes. That's a building, and there's another one, and that should be the end of the map here. Okay. So there's a lot of buildings, a lot of places to hide. I cannot see any melt canisters just yet, but I assume they're gonna be like in this direction, because that's the way you'd usually go. Since there is, wait, how far does this go up? You cannot get on top of this building. That sucks. That's dashing.
Copy that.
I'll put you here. You make full cover out of every half cover. Why can I already hear melt canister? Is that just me? Or is that not a melt canister? Well, we'll throw a battle scanner back here.
Let's get a better view.
It appears the aliens have outfitted the sectoid creature we previously encountered with some form of mechanized body armor. This was likely an effort to improve their combat power. We should exercise caution.
What the hell is that thing? I've never seen one of those. Dude, you look like you're the supervillain from Final Fantasy or something. You do not look like an alien. There's the melt canister. Well, that guy looks tough, doesn't he? What do I have? We've got the sniper. Yeah, it's gonna be great. Let's not uncover that pod just yet. It's just not. There's gonna be more enemies than that pod, by the way. You don't need me to tell you that. But that pod is pretty far away. Before that, we have to deal with these mutons. You've got full cover, dudes. You've got two alien grenades, Thompson. But from here, that's not going to work out.
Heading to that location.
You don't have a visual? No targets available. It's bad. How far can you throw that grenade? Not far. Not far enough. Okay, Overwatch. Suzuki. Quit run and gun. Could grapple, but I don't know where. No, that's dumb. We have to deal with these mutants before we mess around with this stupid thingy back there, with the stupid sectoid mommy. And I should run and gun right now to right here and have a flanking position. With a light plasma, that should be good. And rapid fire as well in a flanking position. Yeah, that at least gets one, because I have to split up my people. They will, they're unlikely to throw grenades when all my people are spread out and they can only hit one. But if there's two people grouped together, they're just gonna go ahead and throw a grenade, and that does huge damage that I do not want to take in the face. So buddy, this is gonna go good. You did not have to break that window. Oh my god! You earned a promotion! Yeah, you deserve that promotion, I have to say. Mech. Trooper. With you, I could have just destroyed that cover, couldn't I have?
In Ordnung, Commander.
I'll put you here. We still have people. Collateral damage, I can destroy that cover with. That is such a nice move. With you, I'm just gonna go ahead. Suppression would be cool, because then I lock them in place, because 60% crit, I'm just gonna take that chance. Good hit. Good hit. Turner, you're the rookie. Well, if Thompson didn't have a shot from there, I'm unlikely to have one from here. They're not gonna fire a grenade this far back. Okay, you just go ahead and overwatch there.
They're backing up. Advance.
dudes. Okay, there's another mailed canister. That's good. I think we've seen all the aliens of this mission. Big ass guy back there, and these three. Can I just go ahead and fire a shredder rocket over there? Question. No. Why not? I don't know. Would have been pretty cool. Sniper. Yeah, you've got three targets. So this asshole backed away. I don't understand why I wouldn't take this shot. 100% chance for with a 100% crit chance. Yeah, that guy's done.
Eyes on target.
Hey asshole, you killed our friend. Don't do that. Nope, sorry.
Moving.
Okay, I'm glad he didn't have Overwatch or some shit. Anyways, this guy is in full cover currently, but these guys back here, the one... Isn't the one right here? They want to cover behind this truck. My guy is easily flaggable here, so I'm just gonna deploy a smoke. Right around here. Right around here. Can you please throw that thing? I'm trying here.
Pop and smoke.
Good smoke. Nice. Thompson will bag up and going into that half cover should be much better than it would otherwise be. You try to find the Muton. No Muton in sight. Vogel, I'm gonna put you back here and reload that gun. Behind this truck, she should not get attacked. It sucks not being able to, you know, do anything. And Rookie, you back up my assault. Moving into flank, those sectoid friendly beings. Why are you doing that? That did not seem like a clever turn. You're asking to get stunned. Never mind. You're not asking to get stunned. But they clearly are pretty scared. Okay. My assault here does have a stunner, doesn't it? Yeah, let's try and move up with a Rookie. You cannot move particularly far.
Solid copy.
Nothing here. He's got to be behind. Visual on the goods. Oh, that has two turns remaining on it. I sure would like that. Running gun is not ready yet. Visual on the goods, he said. That's running, that's not. You cannot take a good cover position. I'm gonna just dash you behind here. That's gonna suck, but this is for the 10 milled. And the Muton is not back there. Okay, that's the important thing. Is this half cover, full cover, but you probably not don't have a good shot from there. Actually, that position is pretty fortified. I'm just gonna let you be in that position. Because that other Muton did something very, very, not very clever. Yep, that's good wording. You could fire a rocket. Yeah, that guy is not gonna be happy about this part.
Going hot.
Mr. Man right there is out of cover, so we just have to put Sarah Vogel somewhere near. Not near enough to see those guys, though. gonna put you here. That should get, have you get a visual. On whom? Since when is he in there? Huh. Huh. No. No. I'm not doing that. Don't look at those guys! No! No! You weren't meant to see them! Fine. It was bad. I'd like to dash you somewhere where you have high ground. That guy activated Overwatch. I'm gonna dash my sniper over here just for better vision. What are you gonna do? No, dudes. He got armor. Are you gonna melee? Mr. Mutan takes cover behind the exploded truck. Sectoid shoots through the wall. I don't know how he did it. There is not actually any. This guy's weird. I don't know what he does. Mech versus mech. I do like this battle. I've got to be honest here. Can I kick you out on the street? Kinetic strike against this douchebag. 6 damage. Why? That does up to 12. Oh, is that melt canister even worth? Well, we'll see. That's only one move. Okay, let's try and collect that. Come on, let me collect that. There's still one more Mutan back here somewhere. Yeah, you're gonna have to take care of those sectoids back there anyways. No. No. Who did you see? Who do you see from there? Ah, okay. Turner, I'm gonna need you to do something clever here. I'm gonna actually need you to hit that target. From... man. That's not gonna work out. That's not gonna work out. That's all that is not... probably not gonna work out. I cannot put you out of cover. I have to put you, like, here. That should be good. Oh, lucky ducky. Okay, I don't know if shooting this guy's worth. My mech is in a very bad position, though. Okay, good damage. I don't have the headshot. 100% chance, 25% crit. Nah. 25% crit is not what I want to see. 3 damage is also very, very mediocre. Sutherland, you could head here and... Who do I still have? I have you, but of course you don't have a visual. So you are not able to shoot twice. That would have been nice cover to have. This is nice cover to have. Please have a vision. Yeah. At least you do that. You do additional damage to mechanized units, so that's gonna be pretty good. And now, what do I do with you? You can get the kill here. You're able to. I'm gonna put you back here. Heading there now. Just one more hit. 90% chance to kill him. Ah, it wasn't meant to be. It wasn't meant to be. Is that Sarah Vogel down? No, that's 4 damage. Mutan and Sectoid remaining. You attacked twice?!
often.
I don't know. I have no clue who is on Overwatch. That's probably my safest turn. I'm able to look in here. See what's going on. Muton and two sectoids back there. Anybody on Overwatch? I have no actual clue. Any full cover? I could just move in for the stun. That doesn't seem safe. That does not seem safe. What can I do with my other people? You have a lot of shots. Actually, who do you have a shot on? Let's make this quick. Headshot. You. You. And the Muton. Not what I wanted. Or is this the three? Yeah. If I kill you...
Dead and gone.
Nah, that was the one with four health. Come on, man. Sutherland, I'd like to heal my guy. I won't move with Sarah. Why can you not move? Like, why can you not dash through that window? I don't understand that. If I put you where Sutherland is, that's gonna be good. So with Sutherland, I'd like to take out this sectoid. What kind of cover do you have? You're just cowering in the corner. So how do I get to him? I only have one more shot. Sarah, you only have vision on this guy. But you should be safe to move in this corner, or should be safe to move over here. This asshole took 9 health from you. I think it's safe to assume that you want him dead.
Der Schuss ging daneben.
Yeah, I saw that. The shot failed to connect. Don't need me to tell you that that was not necessary information. Mechtoid plasma mini cannon. Could I have, like, taken that for myself? I do not know. Why is that not cover?
Roger that.
That's not vision. Oh, come on, dude. You're just gonna have to overwatch from there. And you don't have any vision either. I'm gonna put you behind there in full cover. Now the question, do I want another light plasma rifle or do I want to get a kill? I could get a light plasma pistol back here as well if I do it right. And I don't have many plasma pistols. I have many light plasma rifles though. I really don't know what I want to do. I don't think I could have stunned the Mechtoid, by the way. So... yeah, that's why I didn't do that. I didn't bother with it. Also, I would like that melt canister, so if I run and gun, I sadly cannot fire at two different targets, but I sure as hell can take out that a Muton asshole if I run and gun back here. If I run and gun to this position, you're definitely gonna be in half cover. Have lightning reflex. Okay, that's... all in all, that's not... that could have been much worse. That could have been much worse. Because... wait, where did that Muton come from? I am so glad I didn't move in for the stun. So that's the only guy I have. That... I still have 4 turns for that. Okay. So, how much is my hit percentage? 90% for the kill, or... 100% for a for a kill in of a full health Muton. I'm gonna take that full health Muton down. Nice shot.
Dead and gone. I'm all out.
What the? Ah, okay. Lucky. Okay, didn't take him out, sadly.
That's a need a resupply.
You're gonna shoot at my guy? Missed. Good. That's still in cover. Oh my god. I did not expect there to be three more aliens in here. Okay, game. Game. I'm gonna need you to cooperate. Who do you have a shot on? Muton in the back. 80% chance hit. What can I do with you? I can put you here and stun. And you do have lightning reflexes, so that should be decent enough. If I put you here... That my sniper sadly only has a shot on this Muton. Okay, all my other units, what can you do? Sarah Vogel, you'll need to heal. You will need to get healed. There's no way around that. I'm not gonna let you run around like that. That heals 6? Yeah. I should really get medkits upgraded, but I need thin man corpses for that? Question mark? Do I have a shot from here? Of course I don't. Thing is, if I fail this stun, I still have a shot on him with my sniper, so that's why I'm gonna get this stun.
Sleep tight.
Nice, that's one down. Ride the lightning. Well, with Zara Vogel, she has 7 health. That should be able... I should be able to take another hit from the sectoid with that. And the Seekers are also gonna be unhappy if I put you in here. Kind of shot do you have? 50% on the sectoid. It's to kill. I don't want to kill him. I don't want to kill the sectoid. I just want to not have him kill me. So I'm just gonna put Zara Vogel. Nah, I have to overwatch because of the Seekers. Turner, you're the definition of cannon fodder. And with you, I'd like to just run up on this truck, but that's not happening. I'm gonna overwatch with you because you can see that Seeker merging. You're also gonna overwatch. Let's see what happens here. Overwatching. Okay. I can live with that. The rest is Seekers. I can't do anything about them anyways. Are they gonna merge? No. Okay, what are you doing? You can move in for the stun.
I'm rolling.
He's gonna shoot at you, but that's lightning reflexes proccing. You can take the meld.
Got it.
Got the meld and try the 70% chance.
Subduing target.
Awesome.
Target incapacitated.
Okay, I got my 2 stuns. I should very much be happy with myself. Although sectoid corpses are probably more valuable than sectoid live captives, because I can't do anything with the live captives. Okay, you're just gonna overwatch here. I'm gonna put everybody here to overwatch. That's the only way I know to flush out the Seekers. Overwatch there. Overwatch here. You are gonna run up front to heal Zara Vogel next turn again. Because I think she's the only unit who got injured that badly.
On my way.
You overwatch. Alright. Those guys should kill themselves.
something out there.
You don't say. Of course nothing happens. Of course. Aye, aye. Why would something happen? Alright, let's throw a battle scanner and hope I see some, like, some of them. Since the noise came from here. I see two! Nice! That worked out as well as it could have. Who earned a promotion? I think my I think my assault already got his promotion. So Turner, what are you gonna be? I would have liked you as a like healer or something, but I wonder what happens if I just throw a flashbang and hit both of them. If that makes a difference in terms of what you're gonna become. Although what do I really want with another what would I want with another? I don't know what I'm trying to say here. Support. Another assault would be nice. That's a crit. It's not a promotion. Sutherland. Nope, you don't need to. Thompson, you haven't done much this entire, you know, mission. Maybe get a kill? Nice. That's that. Combat rush.
Commander, the operation was a success.
Yeah, we almost lost Sarah Vogel, but I should have healed her. Ah! Forgot about that. That's my memory in a nutshell. Oh well. I don't have any coffee left. That sucks. I wish I had some like warm coffee. That would be nice right now. Oh, I'm gonna have to deal with these with this outcome though. Promotion gravely wounded. Oh god. Grave injury can diminish their will, and that sucks. Okay, Captain. Captain, Assault Captain. You get Close Combat Specialist. Confers a reaction shot against any enemy who closes to within 4 tiles. Does not require Overwatch. Very, very nice. Or bring him on. Adds 1 damage on crits for each enemy the squad can see. That's a lot of crit damage. That's a lot of crit damage. This can be absolutely overpowered. It can be. But I don't know how to utilize this and it's inconsistent. Whereas this is everything except for inconsistent. It's gonna have this character get a lot of kills. And a lot of damage in on enemies. Within 4 tiles, as long as this guy carries a stunner around, this is gonna be dope. And James Turner, heck, promoted to heavy. Well, that's cool. That's okay. Grave injury, I hate that. Terrific tornado. We get the Mectoid Autopsy and plasma pistol, light plasma rifle. And the captives, and 12 alien alloys. From what? Of course! From the Mectoid! Why wouldn't he drop alloys in Delirium? Okay, that's nice. For engineers, panic in Mexico has decreased by 3. Panic increased across Africa and across Asia. Yeah. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god, I don't want that to happen, man.
Arrived this morning, Commander. We're always glad to have more help down here.
I'm actually building 3 satellites. I just would need the 33 engineers. Not enough. We need 35 for... Wait a second. Wait a second. Build facilities. Satellite uplink. I could be good. I could be no good. That takes 14 days. I could be good. I could be good. Complete transaction. We don't need a Nexus right now. We can have that Nexus next time. We can have that Nexus next time. That adds plus 4 possible satellites, so yeah. Yeah. Let's do that. Because of these adjacency bonuses, this is a very, very nice facility. So, the foundry. We don't have resources, so that would be funny. Drone capture, alien grenades, weapons platform, stealth satellites is very nice. Ammo conservation is very nice. Improved med kits are thin man corpses, yeah. So research is almost done, and we're good. We are golden. Yeah. It's not working out. But on the 25th of June, we'll have another 3 satellites in the running. And I think we already have one more.
Satellite uplink facilities at maximum
yeah,
capacity.
Yeah, we have one more, so we'll be able to put it to maximum next time as well. And then we get... That's 4 satellites, isn't it? I could put them on Japan, India, and Australia and get that bonus all entirely. We already have the bonus in Africa. We'll see. We'll see. Well, let's advance time a little bit. We have that outsider shard.
There you are.
Tactical. Do we have an eagle over these coordinates?
Recon satellite Delta 2 is just coming into line of sight now, sir. Coming on screen.
Nothing.
No, that's impossible. I know it's there.
Switch to thermal.
Hello.
Give me subsurface.
Gotcha.
Reestablish comms with all available.
Think of what we might find once we get inside that facility. Imagine what they might be doing down there.
I'm sure we'll find out soon enough.
Okay, we found it. Now how do we get inside?
I thought you'd never ask.
The methods involved in creating these crystals. An organic machine capable of complex communications. We could spend years studying this technology.
Analysis of the alien shard has revealed that it is indeed organic in nature, although not alive per se. Somehow it continues to resonate within a specific range of the electromagnetic spectrum. Despite several attempts at disabling the alien known as the Outsider, each was met with the same result. The target dematerialized within an instant. With no explanation for this phenomenon, the research team was left with little to study in terms of the Outsider itself. However, having now analyzed this shard, it seems that may not be the case. In an effort to reduce any potential interference from known terrestrial signals, we placed the shard into the harmonic dampening chamber, a device conceived of by Dr. Shin. With outside noise brought to a minimum, it took little effort to detect a very distinct signal, the source of our shard's hum. While we have a number of theories, both the research and engineering teams seem to be in agreement. The shard itself is acting as some form of communication relay. Although purely speculative, we've also considered the possibility that the Outsider itself is merely an extension of the shard and its function. Dr. Shen believes with sufficient time he may be able to develop a device or key that mimics the shard itself, giving us a means to locate the source of the signal. Skeleton keys available for manufacture. This device is the culmination of our research into the shard recovered from the alien Outsider. It should allow our troops to infiltrate the alien base and find out what's inside. Mechtoid autopsy. This robotic cybersuit is designed for a sectoid pilot. It appears that the suit's cybernetics interfere somehow with the sectoid's innate mental powers. We should consider this if we decide to apply this type of technology to our own soldiers.
We were only able to recover the suit's central core, although the pilot's...
Come on.
Corpse also survived intact. The armor itself is quite interesting. The design is highly responsive while still providing extraordinary strength.
As it appears that the sectoid creature within this mechanized armor is of the same biological makeup we had seen previously, most of our efforts were spent disassembling and analyzing the inner workings of the armor itself, in close collaboration with Dr. Shen's team, of course. As our soldiers quickly discovered in the field, the suit is equipped with two substantially larger and more powerful plasma weapons when compared with the standard sectoid equipment. The armor itself provides a great deal of protection to the operator while also maintaining an impressive degree of mobility. The suit is capable of climbing over rough terrain and seems to have no trouble even with staircases and other obstacles, as it is also maneuverable enough to operate confidently in enclosed spaces. One of the more interesting discoveries we made while examining this subject is that the suit's armored plating appears to interfere to some degree with the sectoid pilot's unique mental capabilities. I can assume that this was an unintended consequence of the additional armor plating. The alien sacrificed what would appear to be an extremely powerful ability as a trade-off for an increase in sheer combat power. However, it should be noted that the aliens seem to have offset this potential disadvantage by implementing a new technology. A small module located within the armor's core appears to serve as a sort of amplifier for these telepathic abilities. When targeted by an allied unit rather than linking the two, the amplifier seems to take this power and use it to form some sort of shield around the suit. Our troops should be wary of this capability as the suit is already quite formidable without the additional shielding in place. Advanced Zervo Motors project available in the Foundry. Shaped Armor project available in the Foundry. Advanced Zervo Motors. After a thorough examination, we've been able to replicate the articulated joints of the Mechtoid, allowing for mobility improvements in both our cybersuits and shift units. Shaped armor. The invaders' mechanized cybersuits are of course somewhat more advanced than our own. By examining the interfaces between the armored shells and the cores, we could improve our overall armor design. This has the potential to increase tactical survivability for all of our mechanized forces. Nice. Next up is gonna be... Plasma pistol, not available. I just need a lot more weapon fragments for that. UFO power source. With the element known as Illyrium housed within, this compact device is somehow responsible for engineering the enormous amounts of power consumed by the alien vessels. So we can use this technology to increase the capabilities of not just of our fighter craft, but of mechs. UFO technology research credit applies. With this, I'm able to build a new generator, and I think I might be able to build a new fighter craft, which would be nice. I'm gonna just begin that project. Because it takes 2 days.
I've got a hunch as to how we might get into that facility. Just give the word, and I'll begin manufacturing the key immediately.
Skeleton key, I don't have the 18 bucks.
There
gonna get that.
Some way to get into that base. I wonder what Dr. Shen has in mind.
Nah, let's see. We can just sell a bunch of crack on the black Oh! I can just sell the Exalt weapons. That's, well, they're not valuable, but that's convenient to say the least. Not researched. Mechtoid core. All right. UFO flight computers. I don't need 4 of those. I just need 2. That's a ton of cash. I don't need these. This is enough for the moment, actually.
Aliens are definitely persistent. Whatever it is they're doing, They're not giving up without a fight.
Let's build that skeleton key. Priority. Yeah. Built. And let's see. What
applications for this sort of tech would have been limitless if the aliens had only come in peace.
Advanced servo motors. What do you do? Oh my god. That's a lot of cash, dude. Where am I supposed to get that? That's increase in mobility and the improved shaped armor. Dude, just no. How? I don't know. But that will upgrade my mechs, which is good. I think we got a new medal. Terrific tornado. Plus one aim and will for each mission completed with no soldier deaths up to a maximum of plus 10. That is awesome right now because I probably have plus 10 by now. Aim and will. Award that medal to... How does it look? That's that medal. Award medal to... You already have that, Claymore. You have too many medals. That's one of each. And you're not even that good. Or Skinner. I do like my support. No need. Sadly, Miyafuji, I cannot give that medal to. So it's probably gonna be my my assault that we took with us last time. I only have very little soldiers here. I probably should take care of that next time. We took Suzuki with us last time, so you're gonna get that. That's a lot of aim. I think I only had one mission with a soldier death, and I've had... Yeah, this is episode, like, 17. That's definitely plus 10 to aim and will. So that's a very good medal, the terrific tornado. Okay. Apart from that, let us advance time a... No, never mind. Next up is the alien base assault. Okay. Before we assault that alien base, I hope you enjoyed this episode. My mech is injured for 9 days. I wish I could take them with me, but I can't. So before I go into that alien base and do a bunch of stuff in there that's not particularly smart. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope I will see you in the next episode as well. Until next time, bye-bye!